Okay, so how do we write equations for graphs made up of several line segments and or arrays like these, aka polylines? I might ask my more ambitious students to accept the challenge of figuring it out themselves without any hints from me, but for the sake of time, I'll just tell you here. Let's start with x1. This equation, without a particular constant at the end, actually gives me this, a graph that's a little bit too low. But as mentioned at the end of the last step, we'll worry about the vertical translation a little later. By the way, if you want to get a better understanding of why this function equation works, I suggest that you start by looking at the graph of these absolute valued equations individually, and think of how function addition works. Notice that this one matches the slope of the line segment portion of x1 of t, and these constants match the t values of the vertices. Similarly, the equation for x2 of t is this. Again, notice that this represents the slope of the line segment portion of the graph, and these values represent the t values of the vertices. And the equation for x3 is, maybe you can anticipate what I'm going to do here. One more time, slope of this line segment and t values of the vertices. If we go ahead and add the three equations and combine like terms, we get this equation that you see displayed here. I'm now calling that intermediate sum x subscript 1, 2, 3. Now that didn't take too terribly long, but to speed up the process for getting to this point in the future, pause the video and take a moment to study this diagram. And notice that it summarizes a great shortcut by which you can take the slopes of the polyline and use them to quickly calculate the coefficients in this equation. I'm going to assume that you've already paused and studied this if you felt like doing so. It's definitely worth going ahead and entering this equation into the graph of your choice to make sure that everything is working so far. There, I've typed it in. And as I mentioned, we do see that this resulting curve needs a vertical translation. We expected this graph to go through the origin, 0, 0, right? Normally, I still wouldn't bother messing with that vertical translation quite yet at this point, but just to really prove that this process is working, let's go ahead and do so. You see that this point is going through 0, negative 2.5, and we want it to go through 0, 0, so I need to move this up 2.5. I'll put a plus 2.5 at the end of the equation. There, it's going through the origin. And there, that looks pretty good. Let's compare it to our sketch. Sure enough, same curve.